Hi, have you ever needed to know the population living within a given distance from any point on the planet? Well now, thanks to a new feature we have in both mWater and Solstice, our free data management platforms, you can do just that. I'm Petri, product manager for mWater and Solstice, and in this video I'll show you a few examples of what this means and then briefly go through a live example of how to start using this feature yourself to boost your work. So let's begin. For a while now, we've had this satellite population density information in the platforms as a visual layer that you can look at and overlay on your maps. But what you can do now is bring that information dynamically into your analyses, whether those are your interactive dashboards with charts, your maps, tables, whatever it may be. So here in this example, we see that the system now allows you to automatically take, for example, a water point in this village and set a radius of 1 kilometer and then estimate the amount of people living within that 1 kilometer radius based on these population density estimates. In the video notes, you can find more information about where this population data comes from. It's from satellite information run through some machine learning through data scientists, and it's freely available and now also freely analyzable. So let's look at some concrete examples. Here, we see that it can be used to list various locations by population. This map shows a couple of water points in a country. The yellow dots represent the household density, and this table has listed these water points by population in descending order. So this could be used to prioritize, for example, interventions to repair water points or build new ones to see where you can have the biggest impact and report that to relevant stakeholders, whoever they might be. And the same applies for other kinds of locations as well. Not just water points and boreholes, that can be schools, healthcare facilities, and so on. Another example of how people are using this feature in Haiti this time is to discover untapped potential. So there, a water utility can first of all calculate the known customers near water kiosks that are part of that water utility and compare that against the estimated population of people living within 100 meters of that water kiosk. And by subtracting the known customers from that total population, they can then get to the potential new customers and use that to prioritize their work. And again, the same can apply to all kinds of use cases in business, in international development, even humanitarian work. And just to emphasize this point, that we're not just talking about water, even in mWater, we're talking about all kinds of location data. Here is an example looking at the population within 10 kilometers of a health facility. This map on the left shows such a health facility in a city. And when you click on it in this example map, the system dynamically calculates this population to about 60,000 people from all that point information. But you can take this to a higher level still, in my fourth example, because you can calculate this population data also with shapefiles or the administrative regions that already exist in mWater and Solstice. So the district information, the regional information of various countries. And here we see an area of Rwanda with the list of all of these cells within Rwanda by population calculated here, and the same on a map as well. So really you can bring this dynamic calculation into maps, into tables, and use it at various levels, whatever is most useful. So how do you use it? Well, it's basically just three steps. Once you've started building a visualization, a map, or a dashboard. And in the video links, I'll put some links to guidance on how to build dashboards in general. We have a lot of that available, but here I'll just focus on how to make use of this satellite data. Whenever you're building a widget, a chart, a map, and so on, you need to pick a data source in our platforms. And the key thing to consider here is that you pick one which has location information, whether that is specific GPS location information or the shape in a shapefile. Once you've selected the right and appropriate data source, you then need to get to the population within formula. So that actually accesses the calculation I'm talking about. And you can find this in the formula tab towards the bottom. And it's just called population within, and it describes the formula right there. It allows you to estimate the population within a certain number of meters from a location. And once you've selected that, there's one more step to go through, and that is to configure this calculation. And you don't have to choose many things. You only need to select the field that informs the location. In most cases, this would be the GPS location, such as the exact point of where a water point is, or a school, or a health facility. But it can also be the shape of a shapefile. And then you select the distance in meters. So is it 10, is it 100, 1,000, 10,000 meters, or 10 kilometers? And we'll just look at this option of aggregate results in a minute, but I want to emphasize that we recommend that you filter down this query to at most a couple of thousand water points or schools or communities at a time, so that your query doesn't time out, because counting all those little points is a little bit computationally intensive and takes about 4 milliseconds per site analyzed. So if you've got a couple of thousand, you're already going to have to spend a couple many seconds calculating that. So think about filtering down to the focused analysis that you need. So we recommend perhaps a district level or a single large water utility instead of a whole country. But I just want to touch on the aggregate results option that you can also have. What does it mean? Well, very simply, it means, do you want to combine all the results together, or should each circle count the amount of households within it, even if they overlap? So here on the left side, when we don't aggregate, we see that the upper or northern water point in the example has 2,592 people living within 1,000 meters of it, and the southern water point has 2,364, and that's what gets listed in the table. However, 904 people fall within 1 kilometer of both. So if you want to include that double counting, you don't select aggregate results. And if you do select aggregate results, the system makes sure that it calculates these households only once. So you get this aggregate result for this whole district of root zero, in my example, at 4,052 people, because we have selected to aggregate results. So think about, in your particular analysis case, do you want to aggregate, or do you want to see the list individually? And before we finish, let's take a look at a live example. So I showed you this screenshot of this example a while ago. We're looking at a map of the country of water points, and we have a table that lists these water points on this map and orders it by population. So how do we create this table? I'm here in the mWater portal, and the same applies for Solstice. I'm in a dashboard, and I'm editing it so I see my palette of options. I'll choose to drag a new table to the right side and then click into it to start building it and configuring it. I could choose any data source, whether it's a site, survey, indicator, custom table, but I know I'm looking for water points, so I select water point as my data source here. I'll just pick out the name. Here we see all the data fields that are available for water points. I'll pick out the name. So here we have the names, but I'm only interested in this one area of Tanzania. So I'm going to filter it down by location, by the name of the administrative region, to Busongo. It's just one area of Tanzania that I'm interested in. So I get this list of names. So far, so good. Now let's configure the actual population calculation. Add a second column to my table here, click select, and find the formula. So I'm Now choosing a formula from the bottom of the table called population within. And then I need to configure it by clicking it, and we see this pop-up that we saw on the slides. We need to select the location. So what informs the calculation's actual GPS location? Well, it's the location of the water point, and I want a distance of 1,000 meters. And I do not want to aggregate because I want to see them individually. And there we have a table, but it doesn't quite look like the example table yet because we haven't ordered it. So let's still go and order this by adding and ordering. And how do we do that? We run the same calculation again. So we tell the system to use the population within calculation to order the table. So we get to see this example again. We configure that formula that we selected, pick the GPS location that's relevant, define the distance, in this case 1,000 meters, and now it's ascending, so I click reverse to make it into a descending ordering, and finally we have recreated this table of these water points, and I, as a wash manager, could say, okay, these three water points clearly serve a lot of people, let's make sure those are prioritized in our repairs or upgrades, however it may be. And that's the basics of it. Now it will of course depend a bit on your specific use case. Are you building a map? Are you building a pivot table? Whatever you're doing. And you can find more guidance in the video notes, more thorough guidance on the satellite information as well as the background of where it's all coming from. And here are ways to connect with us if you want to learn more about mWater and Solstice and keep up to date of our constantly improving features. You can find us on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and of course this YouTube channel. And you can always also email us at info@mwater.co or info@solstice.world. And we'd love to hear your feedback on this feature and any exciting use cases you might have, as well as general comments, suggestions, or if you've got ideas for partnership around any topic using the platform. And there we go. So thanks very much for watching, and have a great day.